The other important aspect of our, you know, this was about the wetland hydrology, in that, as I said, there are more than 1,000 wetlands in the and water bodies in the Jhelum Basin. The other aspect of this, you know, component of Jhelum Basin or this river system is the cryosphere. We have huge snow and glacier resources in the state. As I said, if these rivers are still living, I think the reason is this huge snow and glacier resources in the basin. Now, this is important because, you know, in the Indus, if you look at the Indus on this left-hand side here, now you can see that 45% of our water in the rivers is from the melting of snow and glaciers. 45 square kilometers of that small basin are glaciarized, were glaciarized in 1969. Now, if you look at it, you know, we have almost lost 15% of these glaciers. 15% of these glaciers we have lost during the last 50 years almost. What we are seeing, you know, if you look from these results, if you see the 2001 glaciers in 2001 and then 2010, so very little change in the glaciers during the last one decade. And this we are not observing only in this system, in many of the other systems also, because the last 10 years, or particularly last 3-4 years, we had quite good snowfall and in the entire Kashmir Himalayan region. So you can see here very insignificant changes in the cryosphere in this, and that I will show you in some other areas also. Now, but the fact is that 15% of this we have lost. I mean, this is a Suru, this is again one of the tributaries of the Indus. Here again we have lost about, you know, 16% of the glaciated area we have lost during the last 45 years. But we know, you know, as I said, that you know, this the topic of glacier studies is a very controversial and very hot. It has been at least in the past very hot, debated issue here, because as I said, there are more than 16,000 glaciers in the Indus Basin, and we know the controversy we had last year, the IPCC report that all the glaciers in Himalayas will vanish by 2035. But we have glaciers in Kashmir, in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, or in the Himalayan region, which will last for another, even if they recede at the current rate of, you know, rate, they will last for another 300 years. I mean, the glacier like Siachen, which is in one dimension more than 70 kilometers, or many glaciers in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which in one dimension are more than 30 or 40 kilometers. So even at the current rate, but fact is, that out of these 16,000 glaciers, how many of them are being studied? And if you count it, not more than a dozen, or at the most you can go to score. And then can we base our conclusions on the basis of findings from 4, 5, or 10 glaciers, when the entire cryosphere comprises of more than 16,000 glaciers? If you go to the east of Himalayas, if you go to the central Himalayas, and if you go to the western Himalayas, even in the state of Jammu and Kashmir itself, you will have three types of climatic and topographic regimes. You go to the Ladakh, completely different type of a climate system. If you go to the Kashmir Valley, completely different alpine type of a climate system. And if you go to the Chenab or Jammu side, it is similar to the Uttarakhand. So we have completely different type of, and we study few glaciers, and then we say, on the basis of one glacier, we conclude, you know, for the entire Himalayan cryosphere. So I think the problem is there. Now, if you look at this, I'm just showing you some of the, you can see the recession that has taken. If somebody studies this type of a cryosphere, and then this glacier system has receded more than a kilometer, I think at 2 kilometers it has receded for the last 40 years, and then they come up and they say that Himalayan glaciers are receding at a very fast rate, and then somebody comes with this type of a glacier system, which has receded just tens of meters for the last 40 years. And then we say that glaciers are receding, but not at a very fast. And then somebody comes which has not, I visited this glacier in 1988, and I have been monitoring it from 2005 up to now continuously. It has not moved an inch. And now somebody else comes and says that Himalayan cryosphere is not receding at all. But I tell you the fact that all these glacier systems are responding to the climate change or whatever, you know, because all of them have receded in depth. Even this glacier, which has not receded in X and Y direction, but in the Z direction, it has reduced by 13 meters. And this is impacting the every component of the Indus water system, whether it is the Jhelum basin, whether it is the Satluj, or whether it is the Indus, or whether it is, you know, any others. It is this, the changes in the crossosphere, as I will show at the end of this presentation, is impacting the flows in the Indus water system. Now let's come to the another component of my that paradigm I was showing, the linkages, the changes in the land system. Now, if you look at this is a Jhelum basin, and if you look at the figures I'm showing from 1972, and we have many other, you know, in between the data, but if you look at it, you know, the foresters, as in other parts of the India also, are receding, and so in Kashmir also there is a deforestation. But the important thing is the agriculture. You know, when Mr. Ramasamy and we, you know, we met in some type of you know, discussions about the Indus water system, and there was a concern from one side, from Pakistan, because you know the Indus water has another dimension, that is the transboundary system, and between two countries which have a history of hostility. So they were saying that, you know, because the flows have reduced, that India is, you know, diverting the waters of Indus. That is why the flows are coming. I mean, sitting in Kashmir, I know that there is no diversion of the water. But now you see, I mean, they were saying probably the agriculture areas have increased and there is more, you know, diversion of water for agriculture. But if you look at these figures, now you see the agriculture, you know. You can see the number two here, the agriculture area, the land under agriculture has reduced, you know. So if you can see here, the second one, so you can see it has reduced. So what does happen to the water then? I mean, normally there is more water for irrigation, it is pumped for irrigation. Now if you look at this, you know, if you look at the urbanization here, the built up area, the last one. So if you see in the Jhelum Basin, from 5.7 square kilometers in 1972, we have 214 square kilometers of area that are urbanized. And that you can directly relate to the population growth in that basin. I mean, and also if you look at the other components, the horticulture, has, you know, the agriculture is being converted mainly either into horticulture or into the urban area, because horticulture in Kashmir means more and more cash, you know, money. For economic reasons, not for, mostly not for climate change reasons, because still there is enough water for the agriculture, for the water intensive paddy culture. But people are shifting from agriculture to horticulture because it brings them for economic reasons only.